Do you want to create a custom login page for your WordPress site? Well, keep watching. In this video, I'll show you two methods you can use to create custom login pages in WordPress. Getting a custom login page is usually for people who are creating a membership site without using a membership plugin. So if you're ready, let's get started. First, let's head over to our WordPress dashboard. And from there, we're going to head over to our plugins area, add new, because we want to look for a plugin called Theme My Login. Theme My Login is pretty powerful. It allows you to create custom registration and custom profile pages. You can also do custom emails and set up custom redirects. So this is the one we're looking for. Let's go ahead and install now. Once it's installed, you'll also want to make sure that you click activate. So we'll do that next. Now you see it's activated here with the blue area that tells us it's activated. And from here, we have a new tab over in our admin area. So let's just click on the Theme My Login to customize it. From here, you want to make sure that the style sheet is enabled here. The login type, you can choose to do username only, email only, or to make it easier, just do username or email. And down here, you want to select the modules you want to enable for the custom login. When you click on each new module and click Save Changes, we'll now have an area under our Theme My Login settings, like you see here. Once you have that here, you can customize it as you need. Now, a lot of times people want to redirect someone who logs in, say to a particular page. Maybe you're doing a course and you want to redirect them to that course page. Turn on the redirection module here, and then you can go through and set it up. You can do this for all the different groups on your site. You can do that for your editors. You want to scroll down because you're likely going to be doing that for your subscribers. And say when they log in, you can send them to either the page that they were on before they logged in, or send them to a custom page on your site. So that's how you do that with Theme My Login. The second method we'll use is using another plugin called WPForms. If you've recently signed up for a hosting account, you probably already have WPForms Lite on your website. And this will be using the premium version, which allows you to create custom WordPress login and registration forms. Head over to WPForms to get the premium version. Once you download the plugin, head back over to our plugins area, add new, and instead of searching for it, this time we will upload the plugin from here. You can either choose file or you can drag the zip file to it. Once you have it uploaded, click install now. And again, you'll want to click activate plugin to get started. Once it's installed, you'll see this landing page and we can head over to WPForms, go to settings. You'll need to make sure that you enter your license key and verify. And now we're all set to go. Once we have this set up, we need to go to our add-ons area because we need to install the add-on for the user registration. And while we're scrolling through, I'll just say that WPForms, the premium version, is so much more than a contact form. With it, you can accept forms of payment. You can do form abandonment if someone starts a form but they don't finish. You can find ways to still engage with them. So scrolling down, the user registration is what we're wanting. So let's click install add-on. And like with plugins, we need to activate it as well. All right, now we're all set. So let's go over to add new so we can create our custom login. Under the form name, we'll just create a title. And scrolling down, you can either do a blank form that you can start from scratch, or you can go through their templates that they have and find one that matches what you need. Scrolling down, it's the user login form that we want. So let's create the login form. This is the basic form that we'll want. And we also want to go into settings. We want to set up the confirmation. That's what to do once the user successfully logs in. You can create a message, show a particular page, or redirect them to a specific URL. All right, now that we've created that, we're going to save this. And now we just have to do one final thing. We need to create the page where we want this form to go. So I'm going to go to my pages area and click add new. From here, we can give it a title. And from here, you can either add your logo or add an image that you want to show on the login page. You can even add some text here, thanking them for logging in. And what we want to do is there's a new button up here, add form, and we want to click on that. From the drop down, we want to click custom login. That's the form we want, and click add form. And it'll bring in the short code for the WP forms. So now let's click publish and it'll be ready to show. And now when we go to login, you see this custom page. You can also create a custom widget for your site. So we'll go back to our dashboard. Let's head over to appearance, widgets. And if you want a login on your sidebar, then we just go down, get the WP forms, grab it, drag it up to our sidebar area. Select the form that we want to show. Give it a title and save. Now, if somebody comes to your site and they're not logged in, they have an easy way to log in from here. Now, those are two simple and easy ways to create custom login pages without writing any code. Did you learn something from today's video? If so, subscribe to our YouTube channel and we'll send more helpful tips to help you manage your WordPress website. And thanks for watching.